birthday celebrated by Father Johnson, 90th birthday of Isabella D'Souza, special intention of Martin Abraham and family, for the fast recovery of Annal and Aniyak by Angel and Yak. We pray for the departed souls of baby Kim Rodericks, for the soul of Morris Ferrar, for the soul of Rudolph Alvardo and Spiritu, for all departed souls, for the soul of Benjamin Ilagan, for the soul of Corazon Reyes Ilagan, for the souls of James D'Souza and soul of Tony.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Lord will come, and He will not delay. He will illumine what is hidden in darkness, and reveal Himself to all the nations. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Altogether,
I confess
to Almighty God
and
to my brothers and sisters
that I have greatly
sinned in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done and in what I have failed to do,
through my fall,
through
my fault,
through
my most grievous fault.
Therefore,
all the way. The tale of our hearts we pray, O Lord our God, by your divine power, so that at the coming of Christ your Son, we may be found worthy of the banquet of eternal life, and merit to receive heavenly nourishment from his hands, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Now for the love of Jesus, Mary, Joseph, see that there is no walking in. Announce all the prayers of the Mass. Receive the blessings from God.
A reading from the book, the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a piece of rich food and choose wine. You see, rich food and pure choose wine. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth. For the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we look. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let your response be, "I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life."
I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And verdant pastures he gives me a repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. Response,
"I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life."
He guides me in right path for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. Response,
"I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life."
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Response,
"I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life."
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. Response,
"I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life."
Please rise.
Blessed are those prepared to meet him.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus walked by the Sea of Galilee, went up on the mountain and sat down there. Great crowds came to him, having with them the lame, the blind, the deaf, the mute, and many others. They placed them at his feet and he cured them. The crowds were amazed when they saw the mute speaking, the deaf made whole, the lame walking, and the blind able to see. And they glorified the God of Israel. Jesus summoned his disciples and said, "My heart is moved with pity for the crowd, for they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat. I do not want to send them away hungry, for fear they may collapse on the way." The disciples said to him, "Where could we ever get enough bread in this deserted place to satisfy such a crowd?" Jesus said to them, "How many loaves do you have?" 7, they replied, "and a few fish." He ordered the crowd to sit down on the ground. Then he took the 7 loaves and the fish, gave thanks, broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, who in turn gave them to the crowds. They all ate and were satisfied. They picked up the fragments left over, 7 baskets full. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Sisters and brothers, we are in this new month, which is completely consecrated to the Immaculate Conception. Today, as it is the 4th day in this month of the Immaculate Conception, so this 4th of December is the day of Saint John of Damascus in Syria. He is known as Saint John Damascene, a priest and a doctor of the church. And this is the new Advent evening. So the first reading gives us this Advent message, that in heaven there will be no pain, no sorrow, no suffering, no tribulation, no agony, no cross. See how the first reading puts it. In heaven, God will wipe every tear. As long as we are on this earth, we will keep on shedding tears and tears and tears. The Advent message coming from the Gospel is this, that we have a Jesus who is full of tenderness. So as followers of Jesus, we also are called to have a tender heart, especially for those who are in pain. So next time, when you are simply tempted to have a heart made of stone, at once keep on praying, Jesus, Mary, Joseph, Jesus, Mary, Joseph, Jesus, Mary, Joseph, numerous times, countless times, many times, so that your heart can be only filled with tenderness. Amen. Now start a new Advent evening by praying, Jesus, Mary, Joseph, countless times now. The prayer of the faithful for this Wednesday, the first prayer of Advent. In the miracle of the feeding of 5,000 people, our Lord shows us that the Father will give us everything we need. Let us ask Him all the good gifts He can provide us.
Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer. The spiritual food that comes from our Lord's table. Let us pray to the Lord. That government leaders may find ways to respond to the needs of our poor brothers and sisters. Let us pray to the Lord. That those who experience spiritual hunger may find Christ in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who are gathered here may love Jesus Christ as He gives Himself to the multitude in the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died may come to share in the feast of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, You have given us the bread from heaven as food for our pilgrim journey. Guide our steps in the way of justice and peace. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Of love.
becoming sacred mystery and powerfully accomplished for us your saving love, Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Christ our Lord, who assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. And when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for the day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the name of your glory, and without end we acclaim.
Joseph, first powers with the blessed apostles and all the saints who
new ages. We may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and the form of divine teaching, we dare to say,
the